Culver-Stockton. My name is Chelsea, also known as Natural Chels. Justin Strickland was my special in the Black and Gold pageant 2012 Hey special. He asked me to speak a little with you about natural hair and my natural hair journey, things I've learned, things I recommend. Well, let me start off by saying I've been fully natural for 2 years now. I began transitioning my senior year of high school, and I love being natural. Like, I love it. It's so versatile. It's so much you can do with natural hair. Like, it's just, it's wonderful. I don't regret anything, and if I can go back in time, I wouldn't change anything about being natural. During my transition, I can say it was tough. Like, it started off being a little tough. I was my hair has always been relaxed since I can remember. So having that curl, having a comb hard, having to do all of that was really like a challenge for me. So it definitely made me grow patience. During that time, I was wearing twist outs, braid outs, rye set, curl sets, sew-ins. I wore sew-ins. I probably had 4 sew-ins. Like, those probably got me through most of the time. And the product of choice for me during my transition that I would recommend for anyone, especially if you have really coarse hair, I would recommend, it's called Kinky Curly. It's the brand, and it's called Not Today. It's detangler / leave-in conditioner, and it works wonders. Wonders. Like, no ifs, ands, or buts about it. It works great. Like, you don't need a lot, so a little goes a long ways. You can get it from Target, Walgreens sometimes, Walmart. I really can't say for sure of no place besides Target or online. It's like a 12-ounce bottle, and I would say it's like $12, $11.99. But like I said, it pretty much lasts for a while, and it works great. Also, I used a lot of Curl Enhancing Smoothie by Shea Moisture. During my transitioning, I made sure, and still to this day, I have to make sure that my hair is moisturized at all times. Natural hair absorbs water, oils, a lot of things really quickly, especially if your hair is really thick. So you have to keep your hair moisturized. I would recommend coconut oil for everything. Coconut oil and olive oil are what I use the most. I've used a little avocado oils, but, you know, different oils work better for different people. Like, you'll hear people recommend certain things, but it might not work for your hair. You just have to really experiment. But coconut oil is a must. Like, I put coconut oil on my hair all the time. All the time. Still to this day, I use coconut oil. I guess once I had my last sewing that I had, at that point, I was just like, I'm just going to go in and cut off the rest of my relaxed ends. And the only person that I've been seeing that's been managing my hair, other than myself during my transition, during my whole natural phase, is a lady named Melissa at Look After Hair Co. She works in St. Louis. She's great. She has natural hair. She clips my ends. She colors my hair now. She's great. So I let her cut off the rest of my relaxer, and ever since then, it's just been fully, fully natural, and I'm loving it. Like, I love the big froze. You can, you know, the big froze, the puff ball, the all of that. It's just great. I'm sorry that my hair is straight right now. It's not curly. I'm in the middle of flat ironing it. It's blow dry right now. Getting ready for this weekend, but I'll post pictures at the end of different hairstyles I've tried, different colors, just photos along my journey. I'll post that at the end of the video. I've colored my hair 3 times since I've been fully relaxed, which is such a surprise, because growing up I was like, no, I'm never been coloring my hair. I'm never, but I changed that, and I love it. I don't regret putting the color in my hair. My hair is naturally dark, brown, black. I would say black, but probably dark brown. I started off with I guess you could call it the Wiz Khalifa patch, and it's like a blondish right here, and I like that. So I was like, oh, I want to color my whole head that color. So I went and did just that. I let the same lady, Melissa, color my hair that entire color, and I wore that for a while. My hair was growing out so fast. Like, my hair grows pretty fast, which, I mean, it's not a bad thing because I love my hair growing, but with colors, just like, God. So in January of this year, I tried to do something different. I seen a picture and I really liked it, and I kind of was hesitant at first, but I was like, you know, I'm just gonna go on and do it because I want it, and it's just Like, I know my hair can take it. That's another thing with hair color. That's a discussion for a different video. But anyway, I knew my hair could handle it. And so I went and did it. And so I did like a blondish brown, like brown up top. And the back was like a burgundy red. Love it, love it, love it. Like, I post pictures at the end so you can see it. I really liked it. But yeah, with natural hair, you just have to kind of know your hair. You have to get to know what kind of hair you have. Everybody's hair is different. People's hair reacts different to different things. Some things might not work for you, they work for other people. Some things that work for other people, some things that work for you might not work for them. So you just have to really, it's like a trial and error type of thing. But once you get the hang of it, you'll love it. So I recommend being natural for any and everybody. Everybody. It's lovely. Like, it's good. But I don't want to keep rambling and just keep talking and talking because I'll probably get on your nerves. But if you have any questions, comments, concerns, anything you want to ask about natural hair, my hair journey, transitioning products, anything, just leave comments in the comment box. You can ask Justin for my telephone number, text me, whatever. I'll leave my email, my Twitter, my Facebook, my Instagram. I'm always on Instagram faithfully, so you can always reach me on Instagram. My Instagram name is just_chills. Like I said, I'll post that. I have other YouTube videos, so check them out. I plan to make more this over the summer. I've been busy. I'm in school just like most of you all are. So it's been kind of hectic, but I plan to make more videos. So just stay tuned, and I'm so glad to talk with you. Let me know if you have any questions. See you later. MC. In a place to be. You've been waiting for it, I'm waiting too. In my imagination, I be all up on you. I know you got that fever for me, 102. And boy, I know I feel the same, my temperature's through the roof. If it's a camera up in here, then it's only you. But then what I do. If it's a camera up in here, then I best not catch this flick on you.